God is your praise. God is your God, who has done for you these great and awesome things that your own eyes have seen. Please stand.
Thank you.
Christian scripture from the Gospel of Matthew. Jesus said, "You have heard that it was said, 'You shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy.' But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, so that you may be children of your Father in heaven. For he makes the sun rise on the evil and the good, and sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. For if you love those who love you, what reward do you have? Do not even tax collectors do the same? And if you greet only your brothers and sisters, what more are you doing than others? Do not even the Gentiles do the same? Be perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect."
Good morning, everyone.
Constitutions until finally the Wyandotte Constitution
giving women the full right to vote was too radical, so women can vote in school board elections. It's been corrected since. And they also made a slight mistake about the boundaries at the point that the Wyandotte County Constitution was drafted. The Kansas territorial boundaries went all the way to the Continental Divide, including Pikes Peak and the Gold, and what is now known as Denver. That was seen as too large a territory to govern, so the western boundary was redrawn and brought to where we know it today. And that was what was submitted as a document to Congress so Kansas could become a state in the United States, and 2 years later, Congress agreed. But the Kansas Constitution also mirrors a lot of the national constitution, which has been mirrored and described across the globe. And I don't think it's accidental that you're gathered here in this beautiful cathedral, because throughout our history, religion has actually been at the heart of the change and progress that we've made in this country. It's been at the heart of social movements, starting with abolition, the suffrage movement, the civil rights movement, the anti-war movement came out of a religious tradition and religious leaders pushing this country forward to continue to form that more perfect union. So I think those of us here today are really connected with this remarkable American journey that in challenging and troubling and exciting times, we've not only recognized that we've made incredible progress, but that we are called upon to continue that progress. We're a resilient state and a resilient country, and we need to continue to reaffirm our founders' optimism, and they were very optimistic, that we do have self-evident truths, that we do believe in everyone's inalienable right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, that we believe what the abolitionists felt strongly, that people should not be shackled and second-class citizens in this country, and that we are still striving for that more perfect union. Democracy isn't a spectator sport. It calls on us to continue to work to secure the blessings of liberty on ourselves and our posterity. And it calls on those of us who are the most fortunate to continue the progress that we've made. So happy 4th of July, and let's march on. Thank you.
Thank you.
destroy them.
Lord, hear us.
We thank you for the great resources of this nation. They make us rich, though we often exploit them.
Lord, hear us.
We thank you for the pioneering spirit of the men and women who have made this country strong. They are models for us, though we often fall short of them.
Lord, inspire us.
We thank you for the torch of liberty which has been lit in this land. It has drawn people from every nation, though we have often hidden from its light.
Lord, enlighten us.
We thank you for the faith we have inherited in all its rich variety. It sustains our life, though we have been faithless again and again.
Lord, renew us.
Help us, O Lord, to finish the good work here begun. Strengthen our efforts to blot out ignorance and prejudice, and to abolish poverty and crime, and hasten the day when all people, with many voices in one united chorus, will glorify your holy name.
Good morning, a beautiful campus day. Cathedral staff, welcome to Austin. So glad you came and joined us tonight. Thank you for celebrating our nation's heritage. Governor Smithers, thank you for reminding us where we came from and to what we should aspire. Just a reminder that we're open every Sunday. The offering today was all for the Kansas National Guard Family Organization, which supports the Guard's men and Guard women with their family help when they deploy. And we do a lot of deploying these days. My fellow veterans who are here, brothers and sisters, we really welcome you and thank you for your service. There will be a reception, light snacks, drinks in the All-Saints Hall. Immediately following this service. And special thanks to Steve Burke,